Elaine.
This is Dean.
And we are
Grassroots Living.
We had some requests from you guys to do a tiny house tour. We are full-time RVers, but we do own a tiny house and have for a couple years. We actually lived in it for a while and have decided to keep it just in case anything ever happens and we need to get off the road for a minute. We will have a place to go. So today we're going to take you on a little tiny house tour. And since it's a tiny house, we are going to have some little tiny guests helping us. So we've got some neighborhood kids, some former students, and our grandsons, I think, might even help us a little bit. So here we go. We're going to take you on a tiny house tour.
Hi, I'm Kendra.
Hi, I'm Noah.
Hi, I'm Sammy.
Hi, I'm Caden.
Hi, I'm Elijah.
When Mr. and Mrs. Grassy had this place, they didn't have a bathroom. It's weird, right?
Where I'm standing right now used to be the front porch.
But they turned it into a bathroom and a closet.
And here's their bathroom. And on the other side is a closet. The wood is cedar and the ceiling is from an old barn.
Now Papa, show is hiding.
Where is it?
Here's a shower.
There it is.
Hi, this is Mrs. and Mr. Grass's wood stove. They heat the tiny house with the wood stove. They have two buckets, one for kindling and one for firewood. Sometimes Miss Grassy even cooks on the wood stove. Here is where they put the wood in.
This is a Nana and Papa's table. They got from a flea market. It got so larger that they can put stuff in.
So here's the kitchen they have. Even though it's tiny, they have a double sink. Miss Grassy cooks a lot of stuff in this little tiny toaster oven. They even have a refrigerator freezer. Miss Grassy keeps all her food hidden and under here. Hidden inside this potato sack are pockets full of random stuff. When they first bought this place, they didn't have any shelves for the dishes, so they built these.
Okay, so the kids did such a great job taking you on a little tour, so that was really fun, taking them in here one at a time, and they got to help out, and they just, I don't know, they did such a good job. That was really, really fun. So like Caden said, we put in a composting toilet, and if you didn't see our video kind of explaining that, I'm going to go ahead and link that for you so you can check that out. We did a video talking about several different ways to like go to the bathroom if you're like off grid. So that explained the composting toilet. And then Caden also told you about this little closet, but we didn't get to, it's kind of dark, so it's kind of hard to show the closet, but that's our little tiny closet. And I know it looks so small, but it really does hold our entire wardrobe, which like I said earlier, we're not living in it right now. So these are just random things that we're not using. So that's the closet. And again, this used to be the front porch. When we first bought this, it had a front porch, but no bathroom. It just had the composting toilet sitting beside. Well, I'll show you where it was sitting. Okay, so come on into the kitchen. The composting toilet was sitting right here. And I didn't feel the need to do dishes and go potty at the same time. So that's why we built on, we covered the porch and turned that into the bathroom and the closet. Like Sammy said, there were no shelves when we first got here. There was nothing under the sink. This was completely bare and there was nothing above the sink either. So we went ahead and built all these shelves so that we could have a place to put our food and our dishes. Like Sammy said, we hide all of our, we created kind of a pantry here. We put all of our food underneath this curtain under the counter. And I even put some little Christmas lights down here because otherwise it was just way too dark to be able to see anything. So we just lit it up. And Sammy was telling you about how we had little pockets in here. So what I did was I got this little potato sack and I bought a shoe. I didn't use a used one. I bought a brand new shoe rack and hid it inside this potato sack. You might have to stand up to see this. And so it created all of these little pockets So when we're living here, all of these little pockets are full of just different random things. So yeah, so that's a shoe, like a shoe rack that you would use like in your closet, and it's just hidden inside the potato sack. Okay, so like my grandson Elijah told you, he did such a great job. We got this sweet little table at a flea market down by Branson, Missouri. And it was really hard to find this specific table because I wanted one that had the wings on the ends like this. And usually the wings are out here. So this was fun to find this sweet little antique table. And again, there was no shelving at all when we got here. So, excuse me, Dean and I built this little shelf right here. And you would not believe how much stuff fits on these shelves. So, yeah, so we put the shelves here, shopped for a long time, got this little table. This is a chair made by some Amish people over in Jamesport, Missouri. We got our chairs there in Jamesport. It's a fun little place to go. We should do a video on that sometime. When everything opens back up from this whole coronavirus, maybe we'll take you guys with us out to Jamesport. So we probably should have done this at night. I don't know if we're getting a bad glare through the windows, but another thing we did because we really like the lighting that they provide is we added these lights all the way around the kitchen / living room / dining room, and then we also put another string in the bathroom. I'm sorry, in the bedroom. I shopped forever and ever and found this sweet little shelf. So we put that in here. There was nothing in here at all when we got here except for this the counter and the sink. And then if you look over here, we really did a lot of damage on Amazon and got some fun little things to hang our coats and things and a place to put our mail. Those little things right there, that's what we hang, that's like what I would hang my purse on and stuff when we were living here. With this whole coronavirus thing that's happening, we may end up back in here for a minute until things settle down, so we'll see. So if we'll keep going, Kendra showed you the wood stove. So Mr. Grassy does, as she explained, Mr. Grassy does a lot of wood cutting, and we have a place for kindling, a place for firewood, and that keeps the whole place like too warm if you're not careful. And like my grandson Noah showed you the shower, and we actually have that lit up when we use the shower. We have little waterproof lights that are taken out right now, but that it looks really small, but it's actually plenty big enough. And then when I get ready for work, I just pull the mirror out. And this is my area to put on makeup and stuff like that. And then back here, we didn't have the kids show you this part, so I'll show you this part. So this is the bedroom, okay? Again, there was no shelving when we first got here, so we put in all of the shelves and keep our books and just random things here. Maybe we'll do another tiny house tour someday if we move back into it. So you can see, but that's probably a full-size bed. I don't know. It's plenty of room for us. There's a full-length mirror here. Over here is where I put like my hair dryer and straightener and all my hair stuff. And that's it. It's 20 feet long and 8 feet wide. And Dean is gonna show you how we power it because we're totally off-grid. So he's gonna take you outside and show you that part of the tiny house.
All right, now I wanna tell you about how we power the place. We use, as you can kind of see through here, she's gonna show you, 6 235-watt solar panels that all feed into this little shed over here. Has a 6,000-watt inverter with 6 AGM batteries. That's how we power it. So we're completely off-grid with everything that we need. Thank you.
We're so glad that you joined us today, and we're very thankful to Kaden, Kendra, Sammy, Elijah, and Noah for helping us with our tiny house tour. They did a great job.
We do always encourage you, if you like what we're doing here, we'd really love it if you would subscribe. Of course, like this video if you want to do it, share it with other people. We love our little tiny house. We like to refer to it affectionately as the big house, because we actually live in a truck camper much smaller than this. But
so we've been about a month in our teeny tiny truck camper, and so here in a week or two, maybe three at the most, we're going to do a little tour of that, what it's actually like to actually live in a teeny tiny truck camper. So we've got that coming up as well. So we are shaking. I'm sorry for the shaky camera work. That's all I'm going to say, but we're going to go ahead and close it out so you don't have to keep doing a bobblehead thing to watch us. This is Grassroots Living, reminding you to get down to the grassroots of what makes you happy and live your love.
We're thinking of you, and we'll catch you next time.
Peace out.